Alright guys, it's time for another update video, and in this video I'm going to be showing off three CDs that I recently got in the mail. I actually ordered these three, I think it was about a week and a half ago at this point. Actually might be a little bit closer to 2 weeks, I can't exactly remember. But yeah, I ordered these three a few days ago, and so the first two that I'm about to show actually both arrived this past Monday, which would have been the 18th, so 2 days ago. And then the other one, the last one I'm going to show, actually arrived Thursday the 14th, so last Thursday. So, yeah, and I just waited till the other two came in to show all three off together. So let's just get right down to it. So, see, I'll show the one that I got on the 14th last, just because, in my opinion, I think that's the coolest one out of the three. Although some people would think the second one I'm going to show is the coolest out of the three, but I think the other one's a bit cooler, but that's just my personal opinion. But anyway, so yeah, so we're just going to take a look at three CDs that I recently got in the mail, so let's just get right down to it. So the first one I got is another Megalith Records album for the collection, this one being New York Ska Jazz Ensemble Minor Moods. This being Megalith record number 7. I believe this is now the, if I'm not mistaken, I believe this is now the, currently the third oldest Megalith record release that I have. Right behind Westbound Train Searching for a Melody and Victor Rice in America, which those were both sent to me by my friend Punk and Melner 4. This one, obviously this one was not sent to me by him. This one I just ordered myself. So, yep, you see this one actually uses the old original Megalith Records logo, as opposed to the one you see more commonly on a lot of the more recent releases. So that's pretty cool. Yep, copyright Megalith Records 2003, www.megalithrecords.com, and says, ska music, buy it, don't burn it. And I would agree, and I would have to agree with that. So, yeah, cool to add another Megalith Records album to the collection. And there's the disc. And there is, as you can probably tell, there is actually some hidden artwork underneath the spindle. So I'll just take the spindle part out real quickly here so you can see it. Look at that. Actually, yeah, it looks kind of like a record almost. How cool is that, guys? And you can see it actually says Mega 007 on the sides as well, bizarrely enough. So yeah, that's kind of neat that they added some extra artwork to this one on the inside. So, yep, and yep. Tracks right there. Says the same thing right there as well. It's 2002 right there. Yeah, I believe this was originally released in 2002, either independently or by some other record label. And then Megalith Records bought the rights to this and re-released it in 2003. Yeah, something I have noticed, some of these Megalith Records releases weren't originally released by them. They were originally released by some other label, and then they just, like, bought the distribution rights to them and re-released them. So there you go. All right. Up next, this will make my friend Punkamelon 4 very happy. And I actually did already send him a rip of this. I got another Rush CD for the collection, and it's another one from the Remasters series. Rush Karis, or Karis, however you say it, of Steel. Yep, this is the this is their third album. This is the album that was released in between Fly By Night and 2112. So, yep. So this was originally released in... this album was originally from 1975, but of course this CD, this remastered CD print is from 1997. So yeah. So yeah, glad to add some more Rush to the collection, and I did already, like I said, I did already send Punk Nerd a rip of this. So yeah, there's the disc. Interestingly enough, unlike the other Rush remasters releases, the logo isn't exactly the same, isn't exactly as it is on the cover. I mean, it's the same color and all, but that's what it looks like on the front cover, and that's what you get on the disc. See, like I said, it's the same text color and everything, but not the same font, and it's not all like that. So yeah, kind of interesting how they didn't use the exact logo on the front cover for the disc art for this one, unlike all the other remasters releases. But still, it's the same sort of concept. It's just they didn't use the exact logo this time, unlike the other ones. Very bizarre. And of course, you get the image that's on the remastered releases of all the other albums from this time period. I think it's all the ones from 74 to 80, I think. So the debut up to I think it's Permanent Waves, because starting with Moving Pictures and stuff, they used that fingerprint artwork. Believe I'm getting that right. If not, I'm sure Punk Nerd will correct me on that. Because he knows all about that, but I've learned a lot about Rush just from him and just from doing like research and stuff as well. But yeah, so there's the front cover, and of course you get liner notes that resemble the ones from the original album release. There's like all the lyrics and stuff. Interesting how the lyrics are like really tiny on here. So yep, and the back is basically, I guess, just an alternate cover. Yep, and has the copyright and everything. So yeah. So yeah, glad to add this to the collection. Even though I know this album's apparently considered the black sheep of all of Rush's discography. It's apparently like their weakest album, and so much so that no songs from this album are on the greatest hits. Yeah, the greatest hits compilation I have doesn't even include any songs from this album. So yeah, this is, I know, considered like their weakest album, which is kind of why I was okay with buying this one online, because I figured it made more sense to use electronic money towards buying this one as opposed to spending actual physical cash on it, since I know it's apparently the black sheep of Rush's whole discography. But like I said, I still want to get all the remasters releases, so obviously I had to get this one eventually at some point, and well, here it is. But, yeah, still. So there you go. So there's Rush Karis, or Karis, however you say it, of Steel. And then the last one, the last CD I got, this is the one that arrived on Thursday the 14th. And this is pretty cool. This is something I technically already have this album already in my collection. However, I do not have this this particular print of it. And I just found out about like a month and a half ago, when I started getting more into these releases, that this was even a thing. And I knew I had to track this down, and I just went ahead and got this one off of eBay, since I figured it made more sense to just get online than trying to hunt it down at a record store. So, like I said, I technically have this album already, just not this version of it. And but yeah, this is pretty cool. This is Best of Red Hot Chili Peppers What Hits, which is a classic greatest hits compilation of some of Red Hot Chili Peppers' early work. But there's something interesting about this particular print. You may already notice this yellow right here. And what's cool about this print is, take a look at that. Yes, this is an Icon release. Yep, this is an Icon release of Best of Red Chili Peppers What Hits. Yeah, so obviously, as you know, I've been getting a lot more into collecting the Icon releases. And I do want to get all the actual Icon series releases, but there are a few albums that are not technically part of the series, but Icon, I guess, like, bought, like, the distribution rights and re-released them. Obviously, Bob Seger's Greatest Hits was one of them, as you guys might know if you saw that video. And as it turns out, Red Hot Chili Peppers' What Hits was another one that was also re-released by Icon. So, yeah. And also, 3 Doors Down, Greatest Hits album was also re-released by Icon. That one I do have to get at some point still. But, yeah, so this is the Icon re-release of Best of Red Hot Chili Peppers' What Hits. So, yeah, this is pretty cool that they actually re-released this album in the Icon collection. You see on the spine here, it's the same spine as the regular release. They just add the Icon logo to it. The other side. There's the back. So yeah, I do have the original print of this in my collection. Just the regular release, but obviously, I'd much rather have this Icon release, so yeah, I'll probably just be getting rid of the original release, either just trading it in, or I think I might actually give it to the college's radio station at some point. I think it would look pretty good in there. But I'll do something with my original release, and I'll keep this one instead, because this. In my opinion, this release is a lot cooler. So, yes, this album was originally from 1992, but I believe this Icon release was from, 2013, I want to say? Probably. But, yeah, the track listing is exactly the same as the regular release. And you can see it even uses the same disc as the original version. Yep, of course it does the thing where the tracks are all around the disc. Yeah, so it's the same disc as the regular version, and it's just plain yellow on the inside. And they even still use the same booklet. You can see with the track listing and the albums that were out at the time. Yeah, so they literally just reuse the same exact the same booklet and the same disc from the regular release, and then they just They just slapped the Icon logo and made this this like inside thing. So basically all they did was they just changed the spine and the inside of the back cover art. That's literally all they did. Otherwise, it's just the same as the regular release. So there's really not much of a difference between this and the original release, except for just basically that and that. So yeah, other than those two little minor differences, it literally is the same thing as the original release. But still, I figured I would just rather have this version instead of the regular release. So this can go in my Icon collection. But yeah, so pretty cool that this is so pretty cool to have the Icon release of this now. And yeah, there you go. So again, technically, so like Bob Seger's Greatest Hits and Theater's Down Greatest Hits as well, I just found out. Not technically part of the Icon series, but Icon or at least at one point had the rights to it, and they just re-released it. So, yeah, very cool. So, like I said, I'll be getting rid of my original. Actually, I think my copy of the original release I have is actually the BMG release. But so it's not like I could just like swap the disc out or anything like that. But yeah, so obviously I'll be getting rid of my BMG release of What Hits and just keeping this one instead because I like this one better. But, yeah, so cool, add another Icon release to the collection, even though it's not technically part of the series. So, there you go, guys. So, three awesome new CDs for my CD collection. Another Megalith Records release that's pretty cool. Some more Rush, and something unique and interesting for my Icon collection, which will also replace an album that I already have with a much, in my opinion, a much better version of it. So, yeah, so there you go. All right, so that is it. Thank you all for watching this. Hope you enjoyed this. And I guess I'll give a little bit of a spoiler. Well, it's not really a spoiler if you watch Punkamelon Nerd 4's videos. But he did say... He did mention this in his unboxing video, but that he recently posted. But yes, my friend Punkamelon 4 is sending me another box of goodies. I know I have an idea of some of the stuff that'll be in it, but as per usual, there'll probably be some bonus stuff that I was not expecting. So yes, there will be hopefully another unboxing video from Punkamelon 4 coming soon. He'll be my fourth one overall, I believe. Yeah. So, stay tuned for that. So, that'll be coming soon. It says the, right now, the box is expected to arrive, I think he sent it out, I think it was, well, I think he sent it out, this past, Saturday, actually. Yeah. Yeah, it was Saturday when he, sent it, so. Yeah, so, right now, it's expected to arrive, on April 6th, actually, but as per usual, it could come even before that, because all the boxes he's sent me usually come a lot earlier than originally expected, so, stay tuned for another exciting unboxing video from Punkamelon 4 coming soon, and hopefully stay tuned for other new videos coming soon in the future, whenever that will be. So that is it, and thank you all for watching, and as always, have a good one, guys. Peace!